Here in the studio with me is Reverend Sister Emma Obong, Judge. Sister, you are welcome.
Thank you.
Sister, you are welcome to Catholic Television, Kano Chapter, let me see. We want to know more about you.
Thank you. I'm Sister Emma Obong, Judge of Angede, a daughter of charity of St. Vincent de Paul. That is the name of my congregation. Working in Kano Diocese. We are daughters of charity, or I'm a daughter of charity, working with persons who are poor. Those in the society that seems not to be integrated. Through our services that we render to them, they are able to see themselves as a child of God. So with our relationship with them, we make them to feel good, make them to feel acceptable by the societal members, and then for them to also do what normal children in quotes could do in the society. Some are in the school, some are in their different places of work. We help them to be self-reliant and to be of help to others too. So that is basically or the summary of what we do in Kamashina. So I served in Kamashina, Karuku Lugar government, sorry for the pronunciation, and in Kano Diocese here. I came in last July, so probably I'm learning the language, but my experiences with the local persons there, trying to speak with them and for them to communicate with me, there was that a big barrier because I could not understand what they were saying, and them too, they were not able to understand the English. So there was that tendency of them laughing at me and me, I laugh at them. Like one woman who lives close to us there, she will always come around to greet Sabon sister. Sister in Akwana, then I didn't know what it means. So we'll be like, please help me now. I don't know what the meaning of it. She will always say, sister, ba Ausa. And my response to her would be like, madam, ba Churenji. So a lot of fun. With that, I developed interest with the language. So I went into it, asking them, what is the meaning of this? What could somebody say if I need this and that? At least I have small understanding of what Elsa is.
Sister, can you tell us more about where you come from? That is where you will be transferred to this place. Then your experiences, compare them. Let's see how it goes. Was that one better than this, or is this a wonderful experience for you? You know, in this world, they said experience is best teacher. And the more you travel, the more you get to know people, know their culture, know their do's and don'ts, then you will be able to know whatever you want to do. But sister, I want to know, compare this, your new station, and the former place you were. Can you tell us more about it?
Naturally, I don't like comparing places, because there is that tendency of trying to look down on the culture of others. As a Nigerian, I know that culture differs. Where I am coming from, I was originally working in Port Harcourt Diocese, LMA precisely. So those people there, they are very welcoming, you know, easygoing. I was working with them without looking for somebody who can interpret. Everybody understands English. If you don't understand the English, pidgin can flow. And with that, sometimes if I want to go into their own roots, I will try to speak their language, which always makes them to be very happy. And then maybe forcefully try to compare what happened in Port Harcourt Diocese with the one of Kano Diocese. I would say, yes, culture is a gift. And I am privileged, at least, to experience these different cultures. Coming down to Kano State, there is that tendency of a language barrier. It was a bit difficult because what you could say to a client, you are like looking for somebody to interpret, especially when the client come to tell you something of our own secret, because we work under confidentiality. Whatever a client said to us, we try to keep it. It will not be known to others. Unless the client is the one giving you the go-ahead to tell others. But in the case like, I don't understand now, sir, and the person does not understand English. So there is that tendency of calling somebody who could help as a mediator. So it was not easy. In the first months, I came into the diocese. But the culture of this place, I really love it. They are very easygoing persons. very welcoming, appreciative. And then there is that, you know, sister, you came into our culture. Do you know how to eat this? So different gifts. They will be bringing their produce from the farm. So I'm very happy being in Kano State, but I don't know what future will tell of me. Anywhere I am being sent to, I will serve Jesus with my heart.
In case there is a transfer now, they beckon you that you should be relocated to another diocese. How will you feel?
Well, as a daughter of charity, in our constitution, it stated there in number 11 that no misery is foreign to a daughter of charity. We were trained to move at any time. So wherever I'm asked to go, I'm always ready, because any particular place and my name is being called to go, I believe that God has called me to go and serve the people over there, and my mission in this particular place has come to an end. Although there is that mixed feeling, because when you get to know persons and when you are able to, you know, to mingle well with them, that is when the transfer will come. I will be like, Jesus, this is your own will. I will always do what you ask me to do. Thanks, sir. I'll be happy to move ahead. Thank you, ma'am.
Sister, I think there are so many congregations for the sisterhood. Okay? So why do you pick this daughter of charity of St. Vincent de Paul? What is so peculiar about it, or so special about it?
As a growing child, I have been longing to serve God in a special way. I know very well that even when you marry, even when you choose other vocations, the channel or the goal is to make heaven. But I think I want to serve God in an extraordinary way, serving persons who are poor, in which in the society people are running away from them. So my contact with Daughters of Charity was when I was still growing in my parish. You know, sometimes we used to go to the church center to do one or two things, do practice and all that. I came in contact with a Daughter of Charity, their own simple way of doing things. I was not moved at first. But when I listened to all what was going on, there were some persons in the locality there that the sisters were coming all the way from town to be serving them. So I was like, Imabong, you're living in this village. Some persons are coming elsewhere to be serving your own people. So I developed interest. And I went to my dad, Daddy, this family, they don't have what we are eating here. And he complied. So whatever you will buy in the market, I will see the old man dividing into two. But my mom will always be against that we are so many in the family, because we were actually 25. Yes, because my nieces, nephews, cousins, they were there too with us. So we usually work together and experience things differently anyway. So I developed that interest. I want to be a reverend sister. My dad supported, but my mom will always be like, you're the last in the family. When all have all gone to their husband places and to live with their wives, who will stay with me? So I kept giving her that hope. But when the zeal became so much and obvious, she didn't hesitate. And the only thing was to give me a blessing. So I joined Daughters of Charity. Daughters of Charity work simply with persons who are poor. What the so-known persons in the world could discard, these are the persons that Daughters of Charity embrace. Because we believe in the scripture that this person carrying the image of God, God lives in him or her. So we don't try to neglect God in that person, but rather we make the person to be something in future. There are so many of them who are giving testimonies of what God has done through Daughters of Charity. So I want to prepare my place in heaven through my services to persons who are poor. Thank you.
What do you have for our young girls? Do you intend to have new sisters or new members into the congregation? And how do you wish to go about it? And I want you to appeal, because there are so many young girls that out there, they have maybe have that zeal that you have, but they may not know how to go by it. So can you help us and tell them so that the man will know how to do it and become a wonderful reverend sisters like you?
Yeah, vocation is a gift from God. For me, I don't see it to be a force. It's freely given to me, and freely I received from God. So I believe that my stay in Kamashina precisely, and other places, that because I usually go for field work, is going to be through my approach towards them, my way of life will actually challenge them. Those whom God has touched, they will actually come. Like in the places of where we have worked so far, I've had about 3 boys now and 1 girl. So they were the ones who came and said, "Sister, I have been longing to go into priesthood, but I'm scared." I asked the question, "Why are you scared?" He said, "Nobody's to train me. My father is very poor and he complains of money. So how do I go about it?" The only answer I could give to him, "I will be praying for you, but time to time, let us talk so that I will get to know the inner, you know, longing for this going. Because I know very well in my own place, there are people who could not be there, but their money will send somebody to be there on their behalf." So vocation is a gift from God. It's not about force. And I would not like to force any young man or a young woman to become a daughter of charity or to go into any other congregation. So it's going to be through my services. If they like the way I do things or the way the sisters are doing things, they will be encouraged to join us to do the work of God. As it is stated in the scripture that the laborers are few. And plenty of things to be done in the farm of God. Let me put it that way. So Jesus himself knows what to be done. So I'm not the one who is calling, but I am only a symbol of God's love. My name is Kauna.
Thank you very much, sister. Thanks for this wonderful moment with you. And we pray, as you said, the laborer are few and the harvest is plenty, that God, in his infinite mercy, will send more laborers so that we have more reverend, beautiful reverend sisters like you, in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you.